If all viruses disappeared, the world would change, and not for the better. Viruses seem to exist only to harm society and people. From the 1918 influenza pandemic that killed roughly 100 million people, and smallpox is estimated to have killed more than 300 million in the 20th century, viruses have claimed incalculable lives. The recent pandemic is one of several fatal viral attacks that humankind experienced, where official figures estimate roughly 650 million confirmed cases and 7 million deaths. Given these figures and experiences humankind has gone through, it's a no wonder when asked about eradicating all viruses from the face of Earth, most individuals would give a green signal to eliminating all viruses, and that would be a grave mistake. Let's just, for the sake of thought, think a life without viruses and see how things will unfold. Epidemiologists found that if all viruses disappeared, the world would be great for a day and a half, and then all would die. Their worldly contributions of viruses far surpass their misdeeds. Most viruses are harmless and support ecosystems. Others care for fungi, plants, insects, and humans. Viruses contribute to our perfect balance. Because we focus on viruses that cause problems, most people do not realize that viruses maintain most life on Earth. Most virologists research on viruses that cause infections, but a few brave researchers have started studying viruses that keep ourselves and the Earth alive. A tiny group of scientists is striving to present a balanced picture of viruses and prove that there are nice viruses. Scientists know without viruses, life and the planet would end. Even if we tried to kill all viruses, we really cannot eradicate every virus on Earth. However, visualizing a world without viruses helps us grasp how vital they are to our life and how much we still do not know about them. Researchers do not know how many viruses exist. Millions. Or maybe billions. We just don't know. And we may never know the exact number. And also, scientists do not know what percentage of viruses are harmful to humans. However, it is predicted that most viruses are harmless, and the ratio of deadly viruses to non-threatening viruses is negligible or close to zero. So there are very few deadly viruses compared to good viruses. Viruses sustain ecosystems. Phages, which are bacteria infecting viruses, are crucial. Without them, we are doomed. Bacterial populations are controlled by phages in the ocean and likely in all ecosystems. If viruses disappeared, some bacterial populations might thrive, while good bacteria would be outcompeted and die out. In the ocean, more than 90% of living stuff is microbial. Viruses help bacteria produce half the world's oxygen. These viruses kill 20% of oceanic microorganisms and 50% of bacteria daily. Viruses kill microorganisms to give oxygen-producing plankton enough nutrition for high photosynthesis, sustaining most life on Earth. Life requires recycling, thus without death, there is no life. Viruses also control insect pest populations. Viruses will wipe away overpopulated species, ecosystems naturally included. This process, dubbed kill the winner, is frequent in many animals, including humans. When populations are abundant, viruses replicate rapidly and reduce them, making room for other species to live. Competitive species would thrive if viruses disappeared. Biodiversity would rapidly decline. Viruses help some organisms survive or compete. Scientists believe viruses assist cows and other farmed animals convert grass cellulose into sugars that can be metabolized and transformed into body mass and milk. Researchers believe viruses are essential for healthy microbiomes in humans and animals. We are learning more about how viruses interact with ecosystems, including our own. Scientists found proof in another case study. They found in the study being carried out in the Yellowstone National Park grass colonizing fungus, there seems a virus infecting the colonizing fungus, helping grass adapt to hot soil conditions. Thus, plants are able to grow even in the hot soils because of virus. Researchers found that plants and fungi pass viruses down their generations. They think most of such viruses aid their hosts, but they do not know how. And really, the simple question is, why would plants pass them to next generations if they are not beneficial to their species? So, if those viruses disappeared, plants and other organisms that host them might die. Viruses protect humankind. Viruses have saved many lives when antibiotics fail. Oncolytic viruses, which selectively infect and kill cancer cells, are also being investigated as less harmful and more effective cancer treatments. Whether targeting harmful bacteria or cancer cells, therapeutic viruses operate like small microscopic guided missiles that go in and blow up the cells we don't want in the body. For the next generation of treatments, we need viruses. Viral replication and mutation provide a vast genetic resource for other organisms. Viruses invade host cells and hijack their replication machinery. If this happens in eggs or sperm, the viral code can be irreversibly absorbed into the next generation. All virus-infected organisms can utilize viral genes. Evolution occurs through DNA insertion. Thus, eliminating viruses would reduce the evolutionary potential of all species, including humans. Research teams made an interesting finding in 2018. A gene that got passed on to humans from a virus, and this gene is responsible to create a protein that transfers information across nervous system cells to form long-term memories. So in a way, to some extent, our ability to think and retain memory for long-term is a gift from virus. Evidence suggests that ancient retroviruses that infected our ancestors more than 130 million years ago contributed to sustained pregnancy beyond 28 weeks, and our ability to have live births and modern humans were developed from their ancestor species, Homo erectus in Africa, about 200,000 years ago. So, before humans evolved, these viruses helped humankind and its earlier species millions of years ago in their ability to survive. However, the more we learn about all viruses, not just pathogens, the better we will be at harnessing some of it for good and developing defenses against other viruses that could cause the next pandemic. More importantly, understanding viral diversity will help us comprehend our world, ecosystems, and many different bodies of life. We must take time to figure out what is out there, if not for other species, at least for our own good. Hope the next time you hear about virus, you would have a different perspective towards it. And if there is one species among all others that is most important to sustain biodiversity and life on the planet, it would be the viruses that comes first, and thus Mother Earth must be counting on them to keep checks and balances on this planet. We are fascinated by the movie Avatar, in which Iva, known as the All Mother, is the guiding force of life on the planet Pandora. But it is more than fascinating to know. Our own Mother Earth is balancing the life on Earth with its own little unseen creatures called viruses for millions or possibly billions of years. Some species were wiped off using this virus army, and some species were given birth. It could be a part of Earth's plan to decide which species to let live and which species to let go. And where do you think humans stand in this game? Let me know in the comments section. Thanks for watching. And just so that you know, producing such informational content is a tiresome and time-consuming task. Without having subscribers, all these efforts are worthless. Please subscribe so that the channel could survive, and if it makes sense, share this video with others. See you in the next video.